आई असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर मिलन पटेल फ्रॉम महात्मा गांधी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्निकल एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च सेंटर नवसारी. टुडे आई विल डिस्कस चैप्टर नंबर 2 फ्रॉम द सब्जेक्ट रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी सिस्टम्स एंड टॉपिक इज सोलर रेडिएशन स्पेक्ट्रम एंड इट्स मेजरमेंट टेक्निक्स. सो नाउ फ्लो ऑफ कंटेंट्स. First of all, what is solar radiation? Second one is solar radiation measurement techniques. Then different equipments used for solar radiation measurement. First one is pyranometer, second pyroheliometer, third sunshine recorder, then pyrogeometer, then pyradiometer. Now, first of all, what is solar radiation? Now, solar radiation is radiant or electromagnetic energy received on the earth from the sun. It provides light and heat for the earth and energy for photosynthesis process. So, it will provide light and heat on the earth. This radiant energy is necessary for the metabolism of the environment and its inhabitants. So the solar radiation is necessary for the live creatures on the earth. The three relevant bands or ranges along the solar radiation spectrums are ultraviolet, then visible light, and the infrared. So all the three bands have different wavelength, and they are differentiate from each other by their wavelength. Of the light that reaches Earth's surface, infrared radiation makes up 49.4% of the total solar radiation. Then visible light is of 42.3% and ultraviolet radiation makes up just over 8% of the total radiation. Now, each of these bands has a different impact on the environment, and due to different wavelength, the solar radiation or solar spectrum is used for different applications like gamma rays, X-rays, ultraviolet, infrared, satellites, wireless, TV, radio, power line, and MRI purposes. So the wavelength is the most important for the characterize the different solar radiation. The amount and intensity of solar radiation that a location or body of water receives depends on a variety of factors like latitude, season, time of the day, and cloud covers and the altitude of the particular position. Then, not all radiation emitted from the sun reaches Earth's surface. Much of it is absorbed and reflected and scattered in the atmosphere. So, we can see that total energy radiated from the sun is not equal to the total energy received at the earth. At the surface, solar energy can be absorbed directly from the sun, called direct radiation, or from light that has been scattered as it enters the atmosphere, called indirect radiation. So there are main two types of radiations are there. First one, direct radiation, and second one is indirect radiation. Now, this is a graph for the solar energy spectrum. So, it is divided in main three parts. First one is UV, means ultraviolet, then visible or violet, and third one is infra. This is the graph between irradiance, which is measured in a unit of watt per meter square, and watt per meter square into nanometer, and the wavelength nanometer. So these are the irradiance and this is the wavelength in nanometer. So UV band is in the range of 100 to 280 nanometer. This is 100 to 280 nanometer and it is have higher frequencies. It have higher frequencies and it is invisible to the human beings. It is invisible to human beings and it is reached very least on Earth due to absorption in the atmosphere due to ozone layer. Due to properties, it has anti-germ properties. That's why it is used in anti-germ lamps. And the total range of ultraviolet lights is 100 to 400 nanometer. 100 to 400 nanometer. Now for visible light. Now visible light has the range from 400 to 700 nanometer wavelength. And as the name suggests, this range is visible to the naked eye and it is also has the maximum output or maximum amplitude in the irradiance spectrum. Now last one is infrared radiation. It has range of wavelength above the 700 nanometer. Scientists divided them in three ranges: infrared A, infrared B, and infrared C. Infrared A is from 700 nanometer to 1400 nanometer, and infrared B from 1400 to 3000 nanometer, and infrared C stands for 3000 nanometer to the 1 millimeter. So it has largest range of wavelength. In this figure, this yellow portion described the sunlight without atmospheric absorption. So here absorption is assumed zero. And this red portion is actual atmospheric absorption band. So this is the solar radiation after atmospheric absorption band. And this black line is for ideal black body having temperature 5 to 50 degree Celsius. So this is the solar radiation spectrum in form of irradiance and wavelength. Now this is the solar radiation in terms of irradiance and photon energy. So it is the x-axis is replaced by photon energy in form of electron volt. So from this graph we can see that this is the white portion. This white portion is stand for infrared A, B and C. IRA, IRB and IRC. Its range is 0 to 1.5 electron volt. 0 to 1.5 approximately electron volt. And these 7 colors or 7 light colors are stands for visible light. This is for visible light and it is approximately from 1.5 eV to 3.2 eV. And other white portion after this color portion is called ultraviolet A, ultraviolet B portion. So this is the solar energy spectrum in with respect to photon energy. Now, solar radiation measurements. In order to utilization of solar energy and energy balance studies, it is necessary to measure the diffuse and global solar radiation. So, the measurement of solar radiation over a period of time at the place in the best approach for estimating average radiation data for that place. So, five types of instruments generally used to measure three different aspects of solar radiations are: first, pyranometer; second, pyroheliometer; third, sunshine recorder; fourth, pyrogeometer; fifth, pyradiometer. So now we will discuss first pyranometer. A pyranometer is a sensor that converts the global solar radiation which receives into an electrical signals that can be measured. So the basic function of pyranometer is to convert solar radiation into electrical signal which can be measurable. So a pyranometer is designed to measure global radiation, usually on a horizontal surface. So it is used for horizontal surface, but can also be used on an inclined surface. Pyranometer also measure diffuse radiation by using shading rings, and pyranometers measure a portion of the solar spectrum. Pyranometers measure a portion of the solar spectrum rather than full solar spectrum. So it will measure only some portion of the solar spectrum. Then pyranometers must also account for the angle of the solar radiation, which is referred to as the cosine response, because it is used for horizontal surfaces as well as inclined surfaces. For example, for 1000 watt per meter square received perpendicular to the sensor, that is 0 degree from zenith, is measured as 100 watt per meter square, because this 0 degree can be derived from cos 0. We know that the value of cos 0 is 1, that's why 1000 into cos 0 is equal to 1000 watt per meter square. And for 1000 watt per meter square received at an angle of 60 degree from zenith, it will measure 500 watt per meter square, because we know that 1000 into cos 60 is equal to 500 watt per meter square. So we have to multiply our radiation with the cosine angle of the zenith. So now zenith is nothing but zenith angle is complementary angle of sun's altitude angle. It is the vertical angle between the sun's rays and the line perpendicular to the horizontal plane through the point. So it is zenith angle is nothing but the angle vertical angle between the vertical axis and the solar radiation line. So this is the zenith angle, theta z or q z. Now the thermoelectric detection principle is used in pyranometer, whereby incoming radiation is almost completely absorbed by a horizontal black surface over a very wide wavelength range. The resulting increase of temperature is measured via thermocouples connected in series or series parallel to make a thermopile. So solar energy is radiated on the hot junction or any black body, and other side one cold junction is there, and by using different thermocouples we will construct the thermopile by using series or series parallel connection of the different thermocouples. And due to this hot junction and cold junction, some electric signal will produce and it will convert in form of solar energy. So this is the basic principle of the pyranometer. Now the active or hot junction are located at the blackened receiver surface and are heated by the radiation absorbed in the black coating. And the passive or cold junction of the thermopile are in thermal contact with the pyranometer housing, which serves as a heat sink. So this is the basic diagram of the pyranometer. So solar radiations are impact on this curve, and this curve is called dome or window, and it is a protective lens. This is black body, this is a voltage output signal receiver, and this is a thermocouple or thermopile, and this whole composition is called pyranometer. So it's called pyranometer. It is necessary to protect the black detector coating against external influences which may affect the measurement. This black coating must provide protection to influence of the external things. So dome or window is used for protecting this black coating or black body. This is thermopile and this is output voltage. This is heat sink. So influence which may affect the measurement, such as precipitation, dirt and wind. Nearly all pyranometers use an optical quality glass for their hemispherical single or double domes. The dome or window may be single or double type. So the precipitation and dirt and wind can affect the reading of this pyranometer. So we have to provide this dome or window for protecting them from the precipitation, dirt and wind. This is the basic schematic diagram of the pyranometer, and this is the actual picture of the pyranometer which is used in application. Now second is pyroheliometer. A pyroheliometer is used to measure beam radiated by using a long narrow tube to collect only beam direct radiation from the sun at the normal incidence. So it is used to measure the radiation which is direct from the sun at the normal incidence. So pyroheliometer measure direct solar radiation. The amount of solar energy per unit area per unit time incident on a plane normal to the position of the sun in the sky, coming directly from the sun itself. So this equipment is used to measure direct radiation of the sun. This direct radiation E together with diffuse radiation ED gives the total available amount of solar energy on the Earth's surface. The global irradiation Eg can be write E cos theta plus Ed, where Eg is the global irradiation and E is the solar radiation, direct solar radiation, cos theta where theta is the zenith angle and plus Ed means the diffuse radiation. So now schematic diagram of the pyroheliometer. Now it is mainly consist of protective lens, hollow tube, black body and a thermocouple module or the thermopile, and this is the supporting structure for the pyroheliometer. And this is the acceptance angle which is the used to provide the acceptance range of the solar radiation. Only this range of angle which can be accepted by the pyroheliometer, and its range is only 2.5 degree. So pyroheliometer is nothing but one simple circular cylindrical tube which is used to provide सोलर रेडिएशन मेजरमेंट. दिस सोलर रेडिएशन हीट अप दिस ब्लैक बॉडी एंड ड्यू टू दिस हॉट जंक्शन एंड कोल्ड जंक्शन थर्मोपाइल और थर्मोकपल विल गिव वन इलेक्ट्रिक सिग्नल इन फॉर्म ऑफ वोल्टेज और चेंज इन रेजिस्टेंस एंड फ्रॉम दिस चेंज वी कैन फाइंड अवर सोलर रेडिएशन एनर्जी. The main components of the pyrheliometer are a quartz window, a black absorber, a thermopile, the pyrheliometer tube which defines the field of view, and in some cases additional electronics to convert voltage in energy signal. The filtered radiation is absorbed by the black surface on the pyrheliometer and converted into heat. This creates a temperature gradient or a temperature difference from the black surface through the thermopile to the pyrheliometer body, which act as an heat sink. So, due to this temperature difference, some electric signal will generate due to thermocouple. A thermopile consists of number of thermocouples connected in series or series parallel. Each thermocouple will generate a voltage proportional to the temperature difference between the black surface and the body. So the output signal from the pyrheliometer is in form of the output voltage, or it may be in form of change in resistance also. Now third equipment is sun sign recorder. A sun sign recorder is a device that records the amount of sunshine at a given location or region at any time. The results provide information about the weather and climate as well as the temperature of the geographical area. The sunshine recorder mainly consists of the crystal ball having typically 100 cm or 4 inches of diameter, and it is designed to focus the rays from the sun onto a card mounted at the back and is set on a stand. The card is also called recorder card. Each card is marked as to the hour, with local noon being in the center. So each card is marked with hourly base, and at the center of this card the noon of particular area is provided. There are no moving parts, and that's why it requires very little maintenance. So there is no moving parts, that's why sun sign recorder have least maintenance. Now this is the basic schematic diagram of the sun sign recorder, and this is the actual picture of the sun sign recorder. So sun sign recorder is mainly consist of spherical lens, paper strip, support for paper strip, and this is the supporting base. This paper strip is used for recording purpose, and this spherical lens is used to concentrate the solar radiation on this recording tab. So this is the glass sphere, and glass used is crystal clear glass for concentrating the solar radiation. And this is the sun sign recorder card, and it is in form of semicircular, and this is the semicircular brass bar to support the paper strip. So this is the sun sign recorder. Now these are the recorder strips or recorder tabs. This tab is used for winter. This straight tab is used for equinoxes, and this tab is used for summer, and they are marked with the hourly base. So this is 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So at center 12 noon is there. All the three strips have at center 12 noon, and this is the 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, like This recorder consists essentially of a glass sphere of 96 mm diameter mounted concentrically in a section of a spherical metal bowl, the diameter of which is such that the sun's rays are focused sharply on the card. So, a glass sphere is put to focus the solar radiation sharply on this tap. Three overlapping pairs of grooves are provided in the bowl to take up cards suitable for the different season of the year. So, different taps are used for different season for this sun sign recorder. Fourth one is a pyrogeometer. A pyrogeometer is used to measure terrestrial radiation. A pyrometer is a device that measures near surface infrared radiation spectrum which having the wavelength of 4.5 micrometer to 100 micrometer. It measures the resistance or voltage change in the material that is sensitive to the net energy transfer by the radiation that occurs between itself and its surrounding. So, pyrogeometer give the output in form of resistance or voltage change form, and it will measure only infrared radiation in the range of 4.5 to 100 micrometer. This is a schematic diagram of the pyrogeometer. It mainly consists of silicon window for the solar radiation incoming. This is sensing element. This is body temperature sensor. This is drying cartridge. This is sun shield. A pyrogeometer consists of the following major components: a thermopile sensor, which is sensitive to the radiation in broad range from the 200 nanometer to the 100 micrometer. Second one is a silicon dome. A silicon dome or window with a solar blind filter coating. It has transmittance between 4.5 micrometer and 50 micrometer that eliminates solar short wave radiations. So it will not allow to enter the range except this. And third one is a temperature sensor to measure the body temperature of the instrument. And fourth one is a sun shield to minimize heating of the instrument due to solar radiation. Because due to the heating of the instrument will give result with the error. So this sun shield is important to maintain the temperature of this pyrogeometer. The pyrogeometer works based on the principle that radiant energy is converted into heat energy, and that is energy can be measured by a thermopile. And thermopile is consist of series and series parallel connections of the thermocouples. The incoming radiation is absorbed by the detector and the heat flows through the instrument body. The thermal gradient across the thermopile creates a voltage that is relative to the net radiation. So, again, pyrogeometer will give in the result in form of voltage, and it will give the net radiation. So, this is the actual picture of the pyrogeometer. It is look like this. Now last one is pyradiometer. A pyradiometer is used to measure both solar and terrestrial radiation. So pyradiometer is used for both the solar radiation as well as terrestrial radiation. It is also called net radiometer. And for net atmospheric radiation on a horizontal upward facing black surface at the ambient air temperature, it is used. So this is the actual figure for the pyradiometer, and it is also useful for the measurement of the solar radiation. Now previously asked GTU questions. So in May 2019, the question asked that list the different methods of solar radiation measurement and explain any one for 7 marks. In this PPT, I explained you 5 methods. You can write any one of it in this question. Thank you.